Hello everybody, and welcome back to the Vanquish playthrough. It is time for our final mission. But first, there are some Pangloss statues that we can destroy. One up there, and there are two more available to us. If you make sure you go a little bit forward, then there is one there, and then there's one right there. Don't go too far forward, otherwise, you know, you won't be able to get these statues anymore. But they are here if you want them. Like, I mean, that's how close I was to accidentally activating the cutscene.
Thank you for dispatching one of
Yes, it's time for our final boss. And it's going to be glorious.
Nothing better than a smoke to remind you you're alive. You just won't let me finish this one in peace, will ya?
A dead man's last cigar. Take your time.
I'd rather hear something other than bullshit from you.
You want truth, comrade? Here is glimpse. Madam Winters backed our takeover of Russia.
The president was behind your coup?
She promised to support our sovereign government.
We said no bullshit.
To Winters, war was necessary to regain economic footing and reassert world hegemony. What more suitable target than us?
So she used you as a pretext for war?
We had no choice but to proclaim war before we were attacked ourselves.
I can't condone Winters trying to attack Moscow, but you have no right to declare war with a weapon of mass destruction.
The betrayed have a right to retribution. You cannot deny this.
My fight. And I'm gonna end it.
And so here we go. It's time to take on Act 5, Mission 3, Deception. We have two bogeys. Bogey Alpha and Bogey Bravo. Now, you are going to be wanting to be dodging out of the way a lot, going into Ars mode as much as is humanly possible, because these guys are fast, they are powerful, and they want you dead. And also, a lot of this cover is going to rise up and then disappear, so you are going to have to keep moving if you want to stay alive. I would certainly recommend taking down one and then focusing on the other, because that just makes it things a lot easier for you. But you're going to have to use everything you've learned throughout this game to survive. And definitely those EMP emitters are so useful! So, so very useful. So make the most of them. because they do work on these guys, and that can be the difference between victory and death. Also, your best time to attack these guys is generally just after they've launched an attack. So, I mean, as you can see, whenever they do that, they are frozen in place for a short amount of time. Also, once you have taken down enough of their health, they will stagger for a period, allowing you to cause even more damage, which is just absolutely glorious. And for all my awful shooter skills, I'm actually somewhat proud of this run of the boss. Like, I will be brutally honest and say that I did die during it. And then didn't, you know, restart the mission, if only because I was just like, it's such a difficult fight. I didn't want to force my way all the way back through the mission. But I think, for the most part, I've done reasonably well throughout this fight and throughout this game, considering it's not the type of game that I generally play, and as I've mentioned many times, it's not a type of game that I have any real experience in, or generally any desire to play. So I think, for the most part, this has gone remarkably well. And considering I was rather terrified of completely running out of things to talk about partway through the playthrough, I seem to have managed pretty fine in the long run. Now, once you get one bogey down to very little health, this quick time event will ensue, which it's just glorious. And you will eviscerate one of the bogeys. Unfortunately, it was the wrong one! But now, Zaitsev is going to get a lot more aggressive. He's just going to be really ridiculously fast, to the point where you're going to struggle to actually cause any damage. Just hold out long enough, and eventually dialogue like this will happen. Stay alive a little bit longer, and then Sam will tell you to, well, tell Elena to ditch the safety limiters. I'm sure you saw my awful edit. I was wondering how I was going to go about it, because I was just like, do I leave the death in? Do I not? And I thought, I'll just make the dialogue flow as neatly as possible, and then we'll go with that! Once you have this extended R's energy gauge, the fight becomes quite a bit simpler, because you can obviously stay in it for so much longer, you can boost out of the way. You are in a... You have a much greater degree of control, and it really, really, really does help. Obviously, he's still a threat, make no mistake about that, but having this extended R's meter just makes this fight, at least the second half of this fight, much more bearable and much more possible. I mean, I'm sure it's certainly possible to beat the second bogey without using it, but it's given to you for a reason, so make the most of it. And we are getting so close to the final blow. Will it be now, or will it be another... Oh, we're nearly there. There we go. Oh, it was probably a not very clever idea, Sam, but... We are going to have to try our best here and land the final blow. And there we go. The fight is over. And the game is beaten. It's time to see how this all ends.
Elena, this is a slave unit.
He must have been operating them remotely.
Yeah, and controlling both of them at the same time. He stuffed him with tactical nukes.
Bombs are gonna knock the colony out of orbit!
You cannot be foolish enough to think I would let it fall back into American hands.
Damn it.
I would be more worried about my own whereabouts if I were you.
Seeing as how you are actually there.
I'd rather be dead than a slave. Elena, I'm on my way.
There are escape pods above you. Get in one of those.
Sounds good.
Escape pod! Ejecting now!
Okay, Sam. I'll be waiting near the escape hatch.
Don't go making funeral arrangements just yet.
Sam! You're alive! Are you hurt?
we go. Elena!
Sacrificed others to uphold our own ideals.
But Sam, you saved so many more than that.
Yeah.
This is the end of my presidency.
And that rather morbid, depressing ending is the end of Vanquish. They obviously did set up for a sequel, but that sequel has not come yet, and I suspect it probably never will, because that would require Shinji Mikami to, you know, direct it again, and I don't think that's quite going to happen right now. It's a shame, because there's a lot to like in Vanquish. And I mean, this credits sequence is particularly glorious. I mean, what better way to end a shooter game set in space with a shmup, essentially? Because also, it's just really fun, because you get all of the pictures of all of the staff who works on the game. And it really does actually mean that you pay attention. Because, and also it means that you actually sit through the credits, because most people tend to not really care. Something that I do quite like with Platinum is that the majority of their credits ever since, well, Bayonetta, really, have been playable in some form, or at least have attempted to have some sort of playable element. And it just means that you're involved until the very last minute, and it's just really satisfying. And I think this is a really, really awesome way to end Vanquish. I wouldn't say that the ending of the game's particularly phenomenal. It's just that little bit too depressing, and it's very at odds with this very victorious music that is playing right now. But then, it's a weird game that's being a bit of a parody and a bit of not of a parody. So, I suppose it's trying to get away with stuff. And it sort of does. So, I suppose I should probably go over my final thoughts of the game. There will not be any extras for Vanquish, because the only thing that I would be able to show off are the optional missions that you can do. There's, I think, about 6 challenge missions, and they're all rather difficult, and I am simply not good enough at the game, I think, to do them any sort of justice. I will let you go and have a look for them yourselves. There are people who have done it on YouTube, and they have done a phenomenal job at them, and they show how the game really should be played at its best, and I don't think I've quite got the skills necessary to be able to present that. So this is the end of the Vanquish playthrough, essentially. So I will go over my final thoughts. So it's a really fun game. It looks great. It plays great. It's really, I mean, despite having not really played any shooters, it's really innovative, and I'm really glad that this was my first experience of a shooter, because it means that I got to play something that was really new to a lot of people. And it's just so much fun, and it's the type of shooter that does interest me, because it does something different. It's not just your bog standard military shooter that's really quite dull. And also very dubious in terms of what it's espousing. Because, like most military shooters these days, tend to really, really revel in the destruction and the killing of human life. And it's just like, how can we one-up this? And it just gets really a bit ugh. Whereas obviously in this game you're dealing with robots, so that removes a lot of the moral issues, and it's more about being a hero and just taking the mickey out of those ridiculously uber-serious games in the genre. And that's really quite up my street. I wouldn't say that Vanquish is my favourite Platinum Games game. No, that is obviously held by the likes of Bayonetta 2 and The Wonderful 101. But it's certainly not a bad game by any mark of the imagination. It's still what I would classify as among Platinum's best. If you want to go for the lower end of the spectrum, you're dealing with The Legend of Korra's and Anarchy Reigns and Mad World. That's kind of your bottom end of your Platinum Games. Then you've got the mid-tier, which, I mean, all of it's still great, but the mid-tier is where you find Vanquish and Transformers. I mean, Vanquish is definitely better than Transformers. It's much more of a controlled experience, and it's much more effective in what it does than Transformers ever does. So it's certainly edging towards the excellent god tier for me, but because of the whole not really being too fond of shooters and all that jazz, it does just drop a little bit in my estimation. But if you get the opportunity, I would certainly recommend you play Vanquish, because it is an experience that is like no other. There weren't any shooters like this before, and really there have not been too many shooters like it afterwards. Obviously they have, well actually I say that, quite a lot of shooters have taken inspiration from Vanquish since it came out, because if you look at the likes of Titanfall and Call of Duty even, and obviously there was Bulletstorm and all of that, they're all games that introduced mechanics to really dramatically improve your traversal of areas. And that's an incredibly impressive thing to be able to introduce into the genre. I mean, if you think about it, like, the fact that shooters were very stale at this point, and then Vanquish comes along, throwing in all these new tools and new toys, and people take note. I mean, it probably helped that Bayonetta had come out not long before it and made people pay attention to Platinum Games. Then this came along and actually changed how certain games worked and really actually innovated in a sales genre, and that's very impressive. And it was certainly deserving of the awards it got. I mean, it got, I believe, 2 Game of the Year awards. It got 1 Best Shooter award from one place. It got a Best Sci-Fi Game from IGN. It got Best Game No One Played from GameSpot, as well as Best Original Game Mechanic. And it got Most Oh Shit Moments Per Minute from GamesRadar. All of which I think are really excellent awards for it to win. And while there is obviously somewhat reasonable amount of jank, which resulted in the 8 out of 10, 7 out of 10 average for its ranking. I mean, it's sitting at about 84 on Metacritic, both versions. It did get 9s, it did get lower. I mean, there's one 5 out of 10 review written by the wonderful Jim Sterling, thank God for him. Which I would disagree with. It's definitely better than that. But it did very well, review-wise. And deservedly so, because it's great fun. And, well, there's maybe not a huge amount of replay value, because there's not the same sense of ranking as you get in Bayonetta and the other games, which give you medals and all of that, and the way that they're set up is so that you can replay chapters much more easily. Vanquish just kind of sends you through the plot, and once you're done with the plot, there's not too much of a reason to go back, which is a shame. But it's still really, really good, and I would certainly recommend it. And now we are going to see my final score. Let's see. What did we get? So, mission time was 4 hours and 28 minutes. Obviously, that's not quite true. 26 deaths, I'll take that. But it all went good. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you join me in the next playthrough. See you then.